So let me explain to you the evidence for what you're asking, right? There's something called redshifting is where you have the wavelength of a galaxy stretching. That's what we observe. And you can do the experiment yourself. You can bring a photon, you can put it in the box, and you expand the box, it will be redshifted, right? So that is an observation that the scientists see. So yeah. The galaxy itself is not expanding. The space, the fabric of space itself is expanding, right?
Exactly.
That's what the scientists say, that's what they observe.
And the fabric of space is part of the universe, it's not outside the universe.
Okay, so if the fabric of space is expanding, you cannot have something unlimited expanding.
Yeah.
So that's why they say we have a beginning. That's why they moved from the static state theory to the Big Bang theory, right? So if something is quantifiable, is limited, right?
Well,
so
Big Bang theory.
Energy follows the laws of physics, so you cannot say it's something which is.
Sure. So you get my point. You get my point.
You counteracted your entire point because
Why is my point theory? Why is my point?
The word theory.
And
do you understand?
I said observation. You're talking about the Big Bang. I'm not here proving the Big Bang, my friend.
Listen,
talking about the
My point is that it is ignorant to think that what we currently know is everything that there is.
Oh, we are not saying that.
We never said that. I didn't say that.
You said space, you said the universe is expanding into space.
I told you that.
Means you're somehow implying that the space is not part of the universe. The space is part of the universe.
What do you mean, no?
No.
So you haven't grown into it yet.
Do you know what space is?
That there's more for us to know.
Space is not something outside the universe.
What I'm implying is that there's an infinite amount for us to know, right?
Sorry?
We don't deny that.
What I'm implying is that there's an infinite amount for us to know, and granted, basing things that we are learning in things that we currently understand is a good methodology, but it is not guaranteed. It does not mean that this is fact. It means that this is a current understanding.
I accept that, but
and that we should continue growing.
I accept that and agree with it, but this is not what I'm doing.
Yeah.
What I'm doing is that I'm saying we're observing something. It's an observation. It's not just data we're collecting. If I see that the Earth is round, it's not going to be tomorrow become a turtle, right? It's going to be continue to be around.
Yeah.
So when we observe the universe expanding, we're applying absolute knowledge that we see is empirical, right? So we see that the fabric of space itself is expanding. So I'm not using a hypothesis, or I'm using a theory, or I'm
theory. Even if it's a theory, that still doesn't disprove the fact.
Perception.
Yeah.
And so,
perception changes.
Yeah, but that
perception
still doesn't mean the universe will become
fine.
Sorry, that's still one proof. Let's say if you have all the knowledge about the universe, that's still one prove the fact that the universe is expanding, and only a finite thing expands. Like for example, we don't have much information about the oceans even. Does that mean the oceans are infinite? No. It just means that the oceans are finite, the world is finite, the galaxies are finite, and the universe as a whole is finite. No scientist out there says that the universe is infinite.
We're talking about the oceans on this earth.
Again?
The earth is finite.
The rest of it.
Yeah, but you haven't been there.
You know why I brought this into being?
You wouldn't survive if you went down there.
I grew up in a city called Miami Beach.
Doesn't matter. A beach is not the same as the bottom of the ocean.
The reason I brought this into the discussion is not only by the way, limited point.
That's what I'm saying. It's finite.
If I say the creator is
just the oceans, not the universe.
The universe. No scientist says it's infinite.
I have to be separate from something in order for me to create it, right? If I make a chair, I don't become the chair. I have to be before the chair in order for me to bring the chair into existence. This is the second point. There is a third point as well. The third point is that the universe, we say, has a beginning. I don't know whether you will agree or whether you will disagree. That's the same point. Kind of, we will go to the same
point.
Well,
they say it's 14.7 billion years. That means it started to originate at some point.
So if it has a beginning, if that being that you believe in the energy has a beginning, who gave it the beginning? Who created it, right? These are all questions that you will have problematic if you believe that the creator is within the universe. If you believe the creator is holy as well, that's a different problem as well. That means he's everywhere unholy around us. He's in the rapist, the murderer, the killer, the toilet.
That's pantheism. I don't think he believes that.
What we say is
I hope not.
So we apply, I hope as well, right?
You're not pantheist, I'm assuming,
You know what pantheism is?
Pantheism don't know?
Is the belief that everything is God.
No, God is into everything.
But God is in everything. God is everywhere.
Is he in hell?
But it's free.
You said he's everywhere. Is he in hell?
Okay.
I don't know.
Where does energy come from?
I've been there.
Sorry?
You believe that God creates
I'll let you know.
Right. Yeah.
So you believe that God created a specific amount of energy and
that's I believe that. God created everything other than himself.
Sorry, what did you say? Energies?
You believe that God created a finite amount of energy and that's that. Is that what you
are you referring to the laws of physics?
I know. I'm asking you what your belief
is. Listen, what is your belief?
I'm not asking questions to get an idea of where your head's at.
I'm answering you. We believe that God created everything other than himself. So anything you will talk about, God created it. Yes. That's what a creator is.
Okay, even if he created finite amount of energy, what is that proof? Let's say he created finite.
I don't think he's making a point.
I'm trying to make a point. I'm asking questions.
Yes. So is this leading somewhere? Your question? Because it has to lead somewhere, right?
Why?
Well, it's just random questions. We are wasting our time here.
Why is it a waste of time?
No, if it's just random questions, which doesn't lead anywhere, what's the point?
It's never really a waste of time if you learn something.
It's never a waste of time.
So what are we going to learn from your question?
I'm learning something from my question.
Which is?
Your point of view.
That's fine. It's
your
okay.
your perspective.
Okay.
Your perspective.
So from mind. We don't
from,
mind. Look, from,
I'm curious about what you believe.
Sure.
Okay. So from the laws of physics, from the laws of the thermodynamics, we know that energy can neither be created or destroyed in a closed system. Yes? Is the universe a closed system?
As far as we understand.
Good. Then it's finite. Then the energy is finite. Yes. And besides, because if this is what you believe in the law of thermodynamics, yes. Then that shows that these laws of thermodynamics, which again the physical laws, yes, everything is like, they call it fine tuning. There's a fine tuning throughout the universe, you know, the golden ratio and so on, the distance of the earth and the sun and so on. So if you had, you know, the atoms, they were not created like for thousands of years after the first Big Bang, yes, because the heat was so intense that they couldn't have survived. Sorry, when I say survived, they couldn't have been created as an atom. Yes, and this is all from the scientific laws of physics. We know this, and that all points to the fact that the universe is finite, that it had a specific point of origin. Yes, there was things like gravity and radiation and energy and all these things which came about, and the atoms and the molecules came about later on.
So
all this
heaven
is a different realm. You can say it's a different, what do you say? It's a different dimension, yeah. Which we don't know about. So it is a metaphysical dimension, which the scientists will not be able to...
You're talking your language now, metaphysical.
His language? Is he one of them? Okay, good.
Definition.
Then he's definitely not...
Our definition, you tell me what you think, right? This is what we believe of our creator. We believe in one creator, right? We believe that creator is independent. Everything depends on him, right? When we say him, we don't believe he's a man or a woman, right? We don't believe he's restricted by gender, because gender is a restriction.
So I use him.
Sorry?
Why use
it's
him?
A linguistic construct.
Yeah.
So in Arabic it doesn't have it, by the way.
Yeah,
we don't
have it. We're not going to get into binary bullshit.
We have to use one with it, right?
That's fine, yeah.
So we believe the creator is not a man or a woman, right? He's actually described as something. So we believe the creator is something, right? He's above our comprehension. Nothing else is like
don't we creator. Agree on all this so far?
Yeah. We believe the creator doesn't get weak or tired or rests. We believe the creator gives us guidance in life. We believe the creator created everything.
It's eternal, doesn't die.
Right? We believe the creator is eternal.
Yeah.
We believe the creator is obviously omniscient, omnipotent, and these kind of...
Immortal.
We believe he can do what befits his majesty. That's what we believe of the creator, right? So what in the definition I gave you did you disagree with?
So any, how does he
any objections? By
we come to that, but I just remember why he disagrees first.
By scriptures.
I would say it's none of the specific points, but I would say that the limitations, right? So specifically the one that I caught on was that the creator gives us guidance, right?
Sure.
So I believe that the laws of reality are the guidance, right?
The, you mean the laws
structure,
of nature?
The structure of... Exactly.
Yeah, as it called, as it is called.
Exactly. The ways that things exist that you cannot... Like, I can't walk through you. Like,
yeah. But you can kill me.
Yeah.
And according to the laws of nature, this is the laws of nature will not intervene.
Yeah.
So if I'm chopping heads off right now, the laws of nature is not going to stop me.
Yeah.
Does it make it moral action? You see the problem there, right?
So
we require guidance as human beings.
Yeah.
You cannot know right or wrong if you just apply the laws of nature. Right?
Morality is subjective.
You get the point.
Yes.
That I'm
exactly. So there has to be some. There has to be some super natural.
Yes and no, because there are no. Right.
That's the laws.
Morality changes in our generation every time.
One of the laws is also the law of survival, right?
Sorry.
No, that's
the
different.
Law of survival among animals and all that.
If I have money, and someone in the street
that's Darwinism.
Is dying from hunger,
I understand.
So it's not about my survival only.
Right,
is that I'm from hunger,
but
I'm going to help him, right? So
but
it's not just about survival.
No, but you create a certain morality within
your own
existence.
No, the problem
you make
with that
your,
is what? We will have
code
conflict.
Of life.
if you say something is moral and I say something is immoral, we'll end up conflicting. Yeah. Morality has to come with a, from an objective anchor, something outside me and you.
Unless you're saying...
It doesn't, because...
Are you talking about a universal morality? Like, do not kill, do not steal, and stuff like that? Are you talking about universal?
But you know what? You get... There are times when killing is...
That's the guidance I'm talking about.
Who tells you which is right?
It's not a who.
That's the main question.
It's a way that you have to get there.
No, but... Incest moral or immoral?
You have to get there.
But who decides what is right and what is wrong? Who decides?
Stupid question.
Why?
I don't know if it's stupid.
Why? Tell me. I want to know how you would...
We have a border with Canada, right? It's unprotected. We're in the U.S., right?
Mm-hmm.
It's unprotected, and really it gets breached not that much.
What do you mean unprotected? I'm sure there's some immigration laws there.
It's not breached all the time.
Maybe it's not that strong in terms, but there's an immigration law
there. I'm talking
about
getting somewhere.
There are immigration officers there.
Our southern border, on the other hand, is not quite the same thing.
Yeah.
Okay?
But they still won't let you take arms and ammunition into Canada if you as an American wanted to, would they?
I have to make a point, okay? And even if it's a stupid point, I'm going to try to make a point.
No, we would not say that.
I can say it's stupid.
Yeah.
We got there somehow, to a point where there's a stability, where, you know...
Yeah.
So, even though there's laws, or even though we could feasibly kill all the Canadians in one day, because there's not that many of them, we don't. Because... And it's not for any reason.
They're nice people. How would they do that?
No.
Okay. What's
that? They're annoying as fuck.
At least I like them.
But you get to a point in your life. Things.
Yeah.
Fit somehow. I don't think there isn't a God. And God didn't write in big letters like,
I understand you
don't preach Canada. You know?
I understand you believe that.
And Canada.
I'm asking, how would you know that you shouldn't breach Canada?
We don't know that we shouldn't, we just don't. Yeah, because there's a certain amount of civility both ways.
So, do you get my point, right?
Okay,
you get my point.
He's got a point he's trying to make. Let's give him some space.
You're looking for guidance.
The problem
from
is
somewhere.
That the discussion goes everywhere, right?
Of course.
So, the reason here is because, Conor, I like to speak to one to one person, right? As much as I can.
Don't worry.
I try, right?
I know.
The reason is you want to reach a point, right? You want to speak about something. If we keep letting everyone intervene, Muslims will intervene a bit, someone else will intervene a bit, and the discussion will go everywhere, right? We try to stick on our point, right? I'm having a discussion with you. I didn't ask your name, by the way. What's your name?
John. It's going on
John.
YouTube.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's going
so
on YouTube.
I'm talking with you, John, right now, right? I want to know what you believe in. I want to tell you what you believe
cut
in.
Out my
we're
part.
Learning from each other, right? That's the point we're having a discussion. Fair. That's why we don't want to divert.
You can come in after John goes.
Yeah.
No problem.
We don't mind. 100%.
Not that we don't want to talk to you.
Yeah. That's not the point at all.
Yeah.
So what I would say is this, right? You cannot have objective morality, right? Other if you get a revelation from the Creator. Otherwise. We will have conflict.
Yeah, everyone will have
say,
the point
this
of view.
Okay, you'll say no, this is not okay.
But what is a revelation to you? I'm sorry.
Revelation, we believe
it's a communication from God.
Yeah.
We believe in simple terms.
We believe his commandments coming from the Creator. Yeah.
So you get revelations?
No, we call the Quran a revelation. We call the previous messages like the Injil and the Torah. Even the Torah is a revelation for us, yes?
Yeah.
But how many revelations have
so
you got?
Would you agree
Lots.
With that or would you disagree?
Lots.
How do you self
Judaism, but in Islam, belief in the day of judgment is very important, because that is the ultimate day when we will actually be judged by God Almighty, whether we go to eternal damnation or eternal reward, or based on what Allah wishes or what God wishes has been what will be your reward or what will be your punishment. Because you see, there are many people in this world, there are many mafias, many dictators, many people who would go scot-free. They would ruin the lives of many people, kill and destroy property and life of so many people, and they just basically die one day, you know, and no one brings them to account in this world. But you see, on the day of judgment, these people will be frightened of the day of judgment when they realize that they will be held accountable, that they had the power with which they could actually get away from justice in this world, but in the hereafter they will be held accountable by the Most High, and there's no escape for them. And the same thing with regards to people who would do good in this world but without anyone rewarding them, without even acknowledging them, yes? But on that day, they will be rewarded and everyone will know about that. So you see, this is something that we ultimately have to worry about and prepare for. Because you see, in this world, 60, 70, 80 years, and then death is inevitable. So regardless of whether you believe in God, you're an atheist, agnostic, or a believer in God, everyone knows death is a fact.
Yeah. No one can ask yourself and consider that question, what is my purpose? Did you ask yourself that question? Did you say, why am I here? Who brought me here? Who's looking through from inside my human?
You have a copy of the Quran, bro. I'm sorry. You have a copy of the Quran? You have a copy of the Quran? Yeah, if you can bring it, please. Yeah, bring it from anyone, doesn't matter.
Oh, is it finished or are you guys? No,
we haven't finished yet.
Did not come a point of time where human being was not there. Who's not there? Right? When he was not there, how did he become to be? How did he come to be? How did he start existing?
I think this is a segue into his point, if I'm...
Oh, his point?
Yeah, I think I overheard him saying something earlier that...
Do you believe in God, by the way?
No, oh, that will be a different discussion.
Are you an agnostic or atheist?
So it's no different. Evolution, yeah. So
no different from your past point of view.
We'll see about
that. Huh? do you have any specific questions about Islam?
I don't.
That's you don't. Right.
I don't.
So
I
do you think that Islamic principle makes sense? Why giving you?
What you've said makes sense.
Okay. We say that's fair enough, right? And I will get you on
May Allah give you Hidayah.
I'll give you on Quran. I'll give it to read, right?
I mean,
I believe, look, everyone has this innate disposition, which is called fitrah. An innate natural disposition given to you by the Creator. To recognize his existence and to also know vaguely what's good and bad. You know that killing is bad, right? You feel that this is bad. Pushing someone, you feel something, right? We say that's something given to you by the Creator, right? But it doesn't go into detail in life, son. It's vague. Right? But it gives you a sense of morality, right? We believe that thing you have inside of you now, but it's not awakening. We believe when you read the scripture, which is why you call the Quran, it will be awakening. You will know this is actually my origin. This is actually the Creator speaking to me. And there's something between you and the Creator. It will not be between me and you or him or anyone, right? It will be your experience with the Creator. So read the Quran, because I have not found anything more profound in Islam other than the Quran, right? That's what I found that you cannot argue, really. You cannot really falsify, you cannot really argue against, right? It actually reads you. You don't read the Quran, but the Quran reads you, right? That's why I like the Quran. But if you're an objective person, look, if you're reading into the Quran to find something you don't like, you will. If you're reading the Quran objectively, sincerely, it will always guide you.
An open mind and heart.
So, We want to let him speak now, okay, you know? So I will find your Quran first. So give me 1 second.
I've already asked for this.
They're bringing one then. You can go to his point if you like to listen.
Assalamu alaikum, brothers and sisters. Hope this video was helpful for you. This may help others too, so please consider sharing. And we will bring more videos in the future, inshallah. So consider subscribing and you won't miss any. Jazakallahu khairan.